Today, I'll start the installation of the Gaggiuino Gen 3 in a Gaggia Classic E24. Other videos will come. There was too much information, more than 1 hour of video already edited, and I don't believe that anyone would like to watch me for that long disassembling a machine, cutting and connecting wires, and explaining a dense content that you need to be concentrated in order to avoid mistakes in your installation. Then I decided to split. And if you're interested in this content, I recommend you to subscribe and activate the notifications for you to receive the alerts when the other contents are posted. But if you prefer the more than an hour version, please let me know in the comments and I may change the format for my Gaggiuino. One important disclaimer, this is not an official installation guide. In reality, the community is against video tutorials. They believe that hardware and software change and those videos get quickly outdated, so the official source of information is the Gaggiuino webpage and the Discord channel. I'll leave the links in the description. And if this is the first video that you're seeing in the channel, or if you're new to the Gaggiuino modification, I recommend you to check my Gaggiuino installation playlist, where I have an introduction to the Gaggiuino modification, its capabilities, how to buy and install the parts, including accessories like the hardware scale. And I'm covering since the generation 2, and now I'm posting all the contents related to generation 3. So without further ado, let's get started. If you already received your kit from PIC or DIY, the first thing that I recommend you to do is the bench test. Because if you have a problem with your screen, for example, this is the kind of the item that will take longer for you to get a replacement. And for that, you will have to connect all the parts and download the softwares, the firmwares that you're gonna flash to your screen and to your PCB. For the screen, you will have just the updates if necessary. And after that, you will have to install the software using basically two options. So in this case, we are installing Gen 3, and we can update over the air using Wi-Fi. I'm gonna show you how, but if you have some issues with your connection wireless, you may also use the ST-Link. And I'm gonna show you also how to do that with the ST-Link, just in case you need, okay? Another piece of information, you will see that I'm reusing parts of the video about the upgrade from Gen 2 to Gen 3, and it's because it will save me some time in the edition. But the content will be exactly what you need to do to install your Gen 3, okay? Here we can choose PCB. We're gonna install the firmware. So clicking MCU flashing, you will have Gen 3. And then you need to choose what is the release that you will have to flash in your MCU. So basically, there's a code that is composed by the MCU, build type, and the LED controller. If we open here, basically you have the PCB or the legal root. We are going to choose the PCB root. Then the second code is NCP or PCA. This has to do with the LED controller. It doesn't matter if you have LED controller or not, and you don't need to flash the extra defines together with the firmware, okay? The second three letters has to do with this type of LED controller for the time of flight. You need to check if your board has 8 pins or 14. If you have the board with 8 pins in this microchip, you will use the PCA, otherwise it's the NCP. Then we also need to download the firmwares for the screen or the headless. So if you are going to use a screen, you need this UI embedded and UI web. And if you're using the headless, you need the UI headless and UI web. And here we have the UI headless, UI web, and UI embedded. You need to choose one of these and UI web. Another detail that I forgot to mention. You will see here the performance, PCB, and legal, right? And the performance, you have legal and PCB. What is the difference between the performance, PCB, and legal, and the PCB and legal without this performance? So basically, it has to do with the processor that you have. You may have the 411 or the U585. If you have Gen 2, you probably have the SM32F411. And if you have Gen 3, you may have the U585. Now I'm installing Gen 3. Then I'm flashing the performance PCB PCA.bin. Now we are gonna flash the firmware, and for that we're gonna need the STM32 keyboard programmer. Oh, first let me plug my ST-Link. To connect the ST-Link, I like to use some tape to keep the connectors together in the same order, and I think it's easier to connect to the PCB and to the ST-Link, okay? I'll connect to the pins on the top, and if you see, there's a ground, 3v3, data, and clock. You need to remember the colors that you use for each of the pins, so that when you connect to the ST-Link, you don't make any inversion. Then you can connect your ST-Link to your computer. I like to use a USB extension. This cable is, I think, 1.5 or 2 meters long. So here we have the menu. Erasing and programming. Okay, I need to browse the file. Again, here it would be the performance PCB PCA.bin. Here it is. Open. Verify programming is ticked and skip flash erase is not. Now let's click in connect. Data read successfully. Now start programming. Download verified successfully. Another parenthesis here. Now I'm gonna show how to install the user interface updates, but you will do the same procedure for the core upgrade. So instead of selecting UI upgrade package, you will select core upgrade package. Then you will browse for your file. You will find the performance PCB PCA.bin, and you will select and install that file the same way that I'm gonna show you with the user interface, okay? I have the Gaggiuino IP in the network. Okay. Navigate to gaggiuino.local. Let's go to system. Select file. UI embedded. Upload. Select file again, now UI web. And it's done. Here I'm connecting the J1 that goes to the screen. This next is the J9 that goes to the SSR. This is the J7, the DC cables that will be connected to your brew and the steam buttons. Now I'm connecting the pressure transducer. Now, to install the thermocouple, you need to observe what is the positive and what is the negative terminal. In general, the positive is more to the bottom, and you will connect to the red wire. The other screw you will use to connect the white wire, that in general is the negative. Here you can see the red and black wires connected to the SSR. Again, you need to observe that the orange is for the positive and the black is for the negative. Now you can connect to your screen. You will see that there's a black and red wires in one of the connectors that will be plugged in the lateral. And the blue and yellow will be connected more to the bottom in this USB UART connector in your screen. If you're installing the time of flight, the connector is on the back of the PCB. Then you need to pass the wire through this hole. It's a bit hard, it's a small hole and it's difficult to bend. Note that there is the right orientation. You will not be able to connect in the wrong orientation, and don't force too much because you may break it, okay? Then connect the other side to your time of flight PCB. Again, there's the right orientation. Don't force too much or you may break it. Now you can connect the power to this USB connector. You need to see this message, initialization in progress, then filling boiler. The pressure should be zero, and the temperature should change if you add any source of heat to your thermocouple, either your hands or if you have, I don't know, another source of heat, you will see the temperature changing. Another test that you can make is you can set the target temperature to something that is below your target, and you will see that the LED in the SSR should be off because the temperature is being seen as higher than the target. If you increase the target temperature, then the SSR will be activated, and you will see that because the LED will be turned on. If you had any issues with your bench test, I recommend you to open a help thread on the Discord. It worked very well. When I needed some help in the past, they were super responsive, and I totally recommend it. But if all went well with your bench test, you're ready to start the interventions in your machine, which I'm gonna cover in my next video.